Hey everyone, this is Nick. I wanted to show you how you can create a United States map inside of Excel with your values. So you may have a list of, let's say, states, and you might have a list of how many visitors or how many customers came from each of those states. And you can see that right here in my Excel spreadsheet right here. I have state, and then I have the number of visitors. So to make a filled map or to make a map in Excel, it's kind of a built-in chart type. You're going to need to have the state, either the name of the state or the state code, like my two letters right here, Colorado, CO, and you're going to also have to have some sort of numerical value to associate with that map. So I have all of my numbers of visitors right here and my states right here. Now, in order to do this, all we're going to do is we are going to highlight the entire table. You can scroll all the way down. I have all 50 states and Washington, D.C. Let's scroll back up. And now I'm going to go to my Insert tab. Over on the Chart menu right here, you'll see this little drop-down for Maps. Here I'm going to say Filled Map, and I'm going to go ahead and just enter that. You get that little preview. And now you see I have a really nice heat map. This is a nice U.S. heat map or a choropleth map that kind of shows you, gives you a little legend right here, the maximum value and the minimum value right there. Now, you can update a few things on this map and a few things you can't. So the chart title, you can go ahead and type in a title, but you can't move the title left or right, and we always would want a title to be left aligned. So I usually just go ahead and delete that title. I'm gonna put a text box right there eventually in the end, in the upper left. It's gonna be really nice. Now, you can click on this map here on an individual state. You can double click to isolate one state, or you can try and sort of click out of it and click everything. If you right click, you can go ahead and add data labels. All those data labels will pop up. Now, the colors are a little bit strange. I'm not really sure why I'm getting these red and yellow values. It has something to do probably with the theme, the color theme that I have embedded in my workbook. Let's actually go to the page layout tab. I'm gonna show you what it might look like with this is my brand, my Spotlight Impact brand colors. If we go to just the general office theme, you can see this is what happens. Now I get it's actually doing pretty well, it looks like, at being responsive. So on the dark states, on the darker shaded states, we have a white label text right there. And on the lighter shaded states, we have a dark label text, which is really nice for contrast. So that's really nice, but you can also see that there's a lot of tiny states and there's a lot of labels that are just totally cut off. So you're gonna have to really work with this to see if you would want those labels or how you might sort of work with that. I'm actually just gonna go and try to click out of here, click everything, and just delete those labels. Now, the other thing that you can do is you can go over here to the format chart area. Remember, just right click and then say format chart area. There's a few little options that we can play with here. The fill color, this is going to be the fill color, I think, of the entire chart area. You can always fill that with a different color. So say you wanted it to be gray, you can make it gray. I'm just going to go ahead and say no fill because I would usually put this on top of a slide or a report and I would want to see everything in the background there. And then you can also play with the colors just a little bit here on the scale. So go over here to the little bar chart icon, and then under series options, you can see the different map projections, and then under series color, that's where you would set, let me drag this out, that's where you would set the minimum and maximum value. Now, maybe we want the minimum value to be more of a gray, and so I'm just going to kind of put that in there, and then maybe that maximum value I want to be more of a bright blue, and so we're going to put that there. You could go ahead and play with the minimum and maximum color that you want there. So this is one way that you can add a really easy United States heat map to your Excel file. Just go ahead and copy this, put it into your slide in PowerPoint or in Word in your report, and you are good to go. If you like this video, I hope you give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. Don't forget to hit the join button to support my channel with a $1.99 membership. I really, really appreciate that. It helps me keep all the lights on over here, my file storage, my video software, all that stuff. We just got a few new members last week. I think 5 new members last week joined the channel. I so, so appreciate that support. Feel free to cancel anytime. No harm, no foul there. Thanks again for watching. Had a great time making this for you, and I'll see you next time.